What is up, everyone? My name is Joseph, and welcome back to Casually Competitive MTG, where it's our goal to give you semi-competitive EDH content that is both fast-paced and entertaining. In today's video, we have what you want to see. We have the fan favorites from Season 2. And since these are based on your votes, there is no demonic consultation in this video. So those of you who may not find it as enjoyable to watch, I think you're in for a treat. This one's a good one. That being said, before we get into opening hands and deck introductions, we do have a few quick announcements. Due to the fact that we aren't able to meet up regularly like normal, we're going to be streaming over on Twitch, twitch.tv/casuallycompetitivemtg, and we'll be streaming some similar games to what you see on the channel here, just in a live format, so go check that out if you're interested. But we will be using some of those webcam magic games as the background footage for the gameplay videos for the foreseeable future. We're not sure how long that's going to go on for, but it's the best we can do in order to stay consistent in terms of gameplay. So keep in mind that after this video, which was filmed a few weeks ago, that the camera footage will look a little bit different, but the overlay and animations will all be consistent, so you can still expect a high quality video. Anyway, real quickly, if you do want to help support the channel and want to support what we do, we have a Patreon, a YouTube join button, you can follow us over on Twitch, you can join the Discord, you can follow us on Twitter, you can use the TCG affiliate link in the description if you're planning on buying cards, and for those of you who watch the promotions, you can go to casuallycompetitivemtg.com and sign up for the waiting list so you can be the first to know when our merch release goes live on April 17th. Now with that all out of the way, let's get into the opening hands and the deck introductions. Going first today, we have Adam playing Feather the Redeemed. The goal of this deck is just to start swinging as soon as possible. Feather's ability allows for consistent recursion on pump spells and double strike spells in order to get that commander damage through as quickly as possible. Adam's opening hand today contained two planes, a mountain, a sheltering light, an angel's grace, a suppression field, and a sunforger. Going next, we have Joseph playing Niv-Mizzet Perun. The goal of this deck is to play Niv-Mizzet, play a curiosity effect, and then any instant or sorcery will trigger Niv-Mizzet, allowing Joseph to deal one damage to a target, draw a card off of curiosity, and then repeat this loop, killing his opponents. Joseph's opening hand contained a Sulphur Falls, a mountain, a mana crypt, a dispel, a ponder, an arcane signet, and a counterspell. Going third, we have Bill playing Cabal, Consul of Allocation. This two-color deck looks to get insane value off of Cabal's ability, gaining a lot of life, and then having very high value Ad Nauseam and Necropotence plays, with the win conditions being either an Ad Nauseam into Angel's Grace into a Sickening Dreams to discard all the cards he Ad Naused and then kill his opponents, or some graveyard shenanigans like an Animate Dead Leon and Relic Warrior combo with some type of pinger on the board. Bill's opening hand contained a Command Tower, a Mana Crypt, a Slaughter Pact, a Sensei's Divining Top, an Authority of the Consoles, a Mother of Runes, and a Necropotence. And finally, last but not least, we have Jordan playing Sissei, Weatherlight Captain. This deck looks to get fast and consistent activations of Sissei, searching up valuable legendary permanents in order to assemble some type of combo with Nicol Bolas and Jace Cunning Castaway. Jordan's opening hand contained a mountain, a watery grave, an ancient tomb, a talisman of unity, an arcane signet, a Feyborough Elder, and a Dak Faden. Now with the opening hands and deck introductions out of the way, let's get into the gameplay. Adam starts off our fan favorites match by drawing, playing a plains as his land for turn, and giving the turn to Joseph. Joseph draws, plays a mountain as his land for turn, and then for 0 mana, casts a mana crypt. He then taps this mana crypt to cast an arcane signet. He then taps the signet for a blue mana to cast a ponder. He looks at the top three cards, thinks about it, and puts them back in the same order, and then ships the turn over to Bill. Bill draws, plays a command tower as his land for turn, and then casts his own mana crypt. He then taps his command tower to cast an Authority of the Consoles. It resolves, and he then taps his mana crypt to cast a Sensei's Divining Top, using the floating mana to activate it, reordering the top three cards of his library. He then gives a turn to Jordan. Jordan draws, and plays an Ancient Tomb as his land for turn. He taps this Ancient Tomb, taking 2 damage, to cast an Arcane Signet. With nothing left, he gives the turn to Adam. Adam untaps, draws, and plays a mountain as his land for turn. He then taps for 1 mana to cast a Soul Ring. He then taps the Soul Ring and his planes to cast a Suppression Field, floating a colorless mana. There are no responses, and Adam passes the turn to Joseph. Joseph untaps and in his upkeep wins his mana crypt flip, not taking any damage. He then plays a Sulphur Falls as his land for turn, and then immediately ships the turn over to Bill. Bill untaps and in his upkeep loses his mana Crypt trigger, taking 3 damage. He then plays a swamp as his land for turn, and then taps all of his mana to cast his commander, Kambal, Consul of Allocation, floating a colorless mana. With nothing left to do, he gives the turn to Jordan. Jordan untaps, draws, and then taps his Ancient Tomb, taking 2 damage, to cast a Talisman of Unity. On cast, he takes 2 damage and Bill gains 2 life from Kambal's ability. He then plays a Mountain as his land for turn, and then taps his mana, taking a damage from his Talisman, to cast a Fey Burrow Elder. With nothing left, he gives the turn to Adam. Adam untaps, draws, plays a Plains as his land for turn, and then taps to cast his commander, Feather the Redeemed. With nothing left, he goes to pass the turn to Joseph, and in Adam's end step, Joseph taps his mana to cast an end step Factor Fiction. On cast, he loses 2 life and Bill gains 2. He reveals the top 5 cards and has Adam pick the cards. The 5 cards are a Shivan Reef, a Drift of Phantasms, an Island, a Mystic Sanctuary, and a Muddle the Mixture. The Shivan Reef and the Drift are separated into a separate pile, and Joseph decides to take the smaller of the two. With nothing left, Joseph goes to his turn. He untaps, and in his upkeep, takes 3 damage from his Mana Crypt, not winning the flip. He then plays a Shivan Reef as his land for turn, and then gives the turn to Bill. Bill untaps, and in his upkeep, wins his Mana Crypt trigger, not taking damage. He then draws, and plays an Ancient Tomb as his land for turn. He then taps his mana to cast a Dawn of Hope. In response to the Dawn of Hope, Joseph delves away 5 cards in his graveyard to cast a Dig Through Time, taking 2 damage on cast, and Bill then gains 2. He looks at the top 7, puts 2 into his hand, and then the Dawn of Hope resolves. With nothing left, Bill gives the turn to Jordan. Jordan untaps, draws, and then taps his mana to cast a Dak Faden, taking 2 damage on cast from Kambal. Bill then gains 2 and then taps his Mana Crypt to pay for Dawn of Hope, drawing a card. In response to the Dak Faden, wanting to keep his things around, Joseph exiles a counterspell from his hand, pays 1 life to cast a Force of Will targeting the Dak Faden. He loses 2 and Bill gains 2 on the cast, and Bill then loses 2 life to tap his Ancient Tomb to draw another card off of Dawn of Hope. Dak Faden is then successfully countered. Jordan decides to tap his mana to cast his commander, Sisse, Weatherlight Captain. With Sisse on the battlefield, he pays 0 mana to cast a Mox Amber, taking 2 damage on cast. Bill gains 2 on cast, and then Jordan plays a Misty Rainforest as his land for turn, paying 2 mana due to Suppression Field to crack it, searching up a Breeding Pool to the battlefield, and he has it entered tapped. With nothing left, he gives the turn to Adam. Adam untaps, draws, and plays a Rugged Prairie as his land for turn. He then taps his mana to cast a Sunforger. On cast, he loses 2 and Bill gains 2. It resolves, and he then goes to combat and swings Feather at Bill for 3 damage. With nothing left, he ships the turn to Joseph. Joseph untaps, and in his upkeep, does not take damage from Mana Crypt, winning the flip. He then draws and plays a Fiery Islet as his land for turn. He then, for 0 mana, casts a Mox Opal, taking 2 on cast, and Bill gains 2. He then taps his mana to cast a Copy Artifact targeting the Arcane Signet. On cast, he takes 2 and Bill gains 2. He then taps his mana to transmute a Drift of Phantasms. Off of the transmute, he finds an Ophidian Eye and puts it into his hand. With nothing left, he gives the turn to Bill. Bill untaps and in his upkeep loses his Mana Crypt trigger, taking 3 damage. He then draws and unfortunately has nothing to do and has to pass the turn to Jordan. Jordan untaps, draws, and then takes 2 mana from his Ancient Tomb to help cast a Tamio the Moonsage. On cast, he loses 2, Bill gains 2, and Bill pays 2 mana to draw off of Dawn of Hope. Tamio then resolves, and Jordan then goes to combat and swings Sisse and the Fey Burrow Elder at Bill for 6 total damage. He then plays a Watery Grave as his land for turn. Jordan pays 2 mana to activate Tamio's +1 ability in order to tap Feather to make sure it does not untap on Adam's next untap step, and then shifts the turn to Adam. Adam untaps, draws, and then taps his mana to cast a Blood Moon. He loses 2 and Bill gains 2, and in response to the Blood Moon, Bill taps his command tower for a white. With nothing left, Blood Moon resolves, And before Adam goes to change phases, Bill uses this white mana to help cast an Anguish Unmaking, targeting the Blood Moon. Blood Moon is then exiled and Bill loses 3 life. With nothing left, Adam gives the turn to Joseph. Joseph untaps and in his upkeep wins his mana crypt trigger, not taking damage. He then draws and taps his mana, taking 1 damage from Shivan Reef to help cast an uncounterable Niv-Mizzet. With nothing left, Joseph gives the turn to Bill. Bill untaps and in his upkeep wins his mana crypt trigger, not taking damage. He then draws and taps his mana to cast a Fragmentize, targeting Mana Crypt. A Niv-Mizzet trigger goes on the stack, and in response to the Niv-Mizzet draw, Joseph taps his Mana Crypt to help cast an Ophidian Eye, targeting Niv-Mizzet. He loses 2 on cast, and Bill gains 2. Bill decides to pay 2 mana to draw off of Dawn of Hope, and then in response to the Ophidian Eye cast, Bill, for 0 mana, casts a Slaughter Pact, targeting Niv-Mizzet. Joseph draws off of Niv-Mizzet and deals 1 damage to Bill's face, and then the Slaughter Pact resolves, killing Niv-Mizzet. The stack then resolves, the Ophidian Eye fizzles without a target, Joseph draws a card, and then with the stack clear, Bill plays a Polluted Delta as his land for turn, taps his Ancient Tomb, taking 2 damage to cast an Arcane Signet. He then taps his mana to cast a Putrid Imp. With nothing left, he goes to pass the turn to Jordan. In response to Bill moving to his end step, Adam taps his mana to cast a Sheltering Light, targeting Feather. He takes 2, Bill gains 2, and Adam then scries 1 card to the bottom. Jordan then goes to his turn, untaps, draws, and immediately goes to combat, swinging his Feyborough Elder at Bill. Bill decides to block with his Putrid Imp, and in Jordan's second main phase, he pays 1 of each color and 2 colorless due to suppression field to activate his commander, searching up an Oath of Ajani to the battlefield. When it enters, he puts a +1/+1 counter on each of his creatures, and then pays 2 mana to use Tamiyo's -2 ability, targeting Adam in order to draw a card. He then plays a Wooded Foothills as his land for turn, and with nothing left, goes to move to his end step, and in response to moving to his end step, Adam again casts Sheltering Light, targeting his commander, scrying 1 card to the bottom, and then Jordan moves to his end step, and Adam returns the spell to his hand. Adam untaps, draws, and plays a Plains as his land for turn. He then taps his mana to equip his Sunforger to Feather. He then goes to combat and swings Feather at Bill, who declares no blockers, and Bill then takes 7 more commander damage. With nothing left, Adam gives the turn to Joseph. Joseph untaps, draws, and then plays a Cephalid Colosseum as his land for turn, and then taps his mana to again cast Niv-Mizzet. In response to the cast, Bill taps for 1 black mana to cast an Entomb. Entomb resolves, and Bill searches up Avilla's Broker of Blood to his graveyard. With nothing left, Niv-Mizzet then resolves, and Joseph gives the turn to Bill. Bill untaps, and in his upkeep pays the mana for Slaughter Pact in order to not lose the game. He then, also in his upkeep, wins his mana grip trigger, not taking damage. He then taps his Ancient Tomb, taking 2, to crack his Polluted Delta to search up a Swamp to the battlefield. He then taps his mana to play a Necropotence. He then goes to activate Necropotence, and Adam decides to remind him that it will cost 2 mana each activation, and Bill then goes to pass the turn to Jordan. In response to going to end step, Adam pays mana to cast Sheltering Light, again targeting Feather, taking 2, Bill gains 2, and Joseph draws a card off of Niv-Mizzet. He decides to deal 1 damage to Bill's face with the draw. Adam then scries 1 card to the bottom, and then, before moving to his turn, still in Bill's end step, Jordan pays his mana to crack his Warded Foothills, searching up a Steam Vents to the battlefield, tapped. Jordan then finally goes to his turn. He untaps, draws, and again immediately goes to combat, swinging his 6 power Sisse at Joseph and his 4 powered Feyborough at Bill. No blockers are declared, the damage is dealt, and in his second main phase, Jordan pays the required mana to activate his commander again, searching up Avraska the Unseen to the battlefield. He then taps Feyborough Elder, floating 4 mana, and then uses this 4 mana to +1 Avraska and -2 Tamiyo, targeting himself, to draw 2 cards. In response, Adam yet again casts Sheltering Light, targeting his commander. Taking 2 damage on cast, Bill gains 2, and Joseph draws a card off of Niv-Mizzet, dealing 1 damage to Tamiyo. Adam scries a card to the top, and the Tamiyo activation then resolves. Jordan decides to play a Scalding Tarn as his land for turn, and then give the turn to Adam. Adam untaps, draws, and plays a mountain as his land for turn. He then goes to combat, declaring Feather as an attacker at Joseph. Joseph declares no blockers, and in response to going to damage, Adam taps his mana to cast a Psychotic Fury. He takes 2 damage on cast, Bill gains 2, and Joseph draws a card, and realizing what's coming, decides to deal 1 damage to Feather. Psychotic Fury then resolves, Adam draws a card, and with no further responses, Feather deals 14 damage to Joseph. Joseph, with not enough life to survive, dies. Adam then passes the turn. Bill, on his turn, untaps, and in his upkeep, loses his mana crypt trigger, taking 3 damage. Bill takes 2 life to tap his Ancient Tomb and his mana crypt in order to activate Necropotence twice. He pays 2 life to exile 2 cards and puts them aside. He then goes to combat and declares Kambal as an attacker at Adam. Adam takes the 2 damage, and Bill then goes to his end step to put the Necropotence cards to his hand. In Bill's end step, Jordan taps his Ancient Tomb, taking 2 life in order to crack his Scalding Tarn, taking another damage, to search up a Sacred Foundry to the battlefield and has it enter tapped. He then goes to his turn, untaps, draws, and taps his Ancient Tomb, taking 2 damage to generate 2 mana in order to activate Vraska's -2 ability, destroying a permanent targeting suppression field. It resolves, suppression field is destroyed, and Jordan then activates his commander to search up a Nico Bolas the Dragon God to the battlefield. He then goes to combat and swings Sisay and Feyburrow Elder at Adam for 14 total damage. He then, in his second main phase, taps his Elder for 5 mana in order to activate Sisay again to put Jace Cunning Castaway onto the battlefield, and then activates Nico Bolas's -3 ability targeting Feather the Redeemed. In order to save his commander, Adam, when it gets to him, taps his mana to cast a Sheltering Light, attempting to give his commander indestructible. On cast, he loses 2 life and Bill gains 2. Bill decides to pay 2 mana into Dawn of Hope to draw a card, and then in response to the Sheltering Light, Jordan, for 0 mana, casts a Pact of Negation, attempting to counter it. Jordan loses 2, Bill gains 2, and in response to the Pact of Negation, Adam, wanting to keep his commander around, taps his mana to unequip Sunforger to search up a Pyroblast, and casts it without paying its mana cost, targeting the Pact of Negation. He loses 2 on cast, Bill gains 2, and Bill decides to pay 2 mana to draw a card, and Pyroblast then resolves, countering the Pact of Negation. Feather the Redeemed is then given indestructible by the Sheltering Light and does not die to Nico Bolas's ability. Adam also scries 1 card to the bottom from his Sheltering Light resolving. Jordan, with his plans of destroying Feather now gone, decides to activate Jace's -2 ability in order to create a 2-2 illusion. Jordan then plays a Karn's Bastion as his land for turn, and with nothing left, he goes to his end step, Adam gets his indestructible spell yet again back to his hand, and Adam then goes to his turn, untapping, drawing a card for turn, and he then pays mana to re-equip Sunforger to Feather. He then goes to combat, declares Feather as an attacker at Bill, and in response to going to blockers, Adam taps his mana to cast a Psychotic Fury, again targeting Feather the Redeemed. On cast, he takes 2 damage, Bill gains 2 life, and Feather then gets double strike, and Adam gets to draw a card. Bill then declares no blockers and dies to commander damage. In his second main phase, Adam plays a Plains as his land for turn, and then taps his mana to unequip Sunforger from his commander, to search up a Path to Exile, and casts the Path, targeting Feyburrow Elder. Path resolves, and Jordan decides to search up a Plains to his battlefield, off of Path. With nothing left, Adam goes to pass the turn to Jordan. Jordan untaps and immediately goes to combat, swinging Sisay and the 2-2 illusion at Adam. In response to going to blockers, Adam taps for 1 white mana to cast an Angel's Grace to hold on for at least 1 more turn. The damage goes through and Adam goes down to 1. Jordan then, in a second main phase, taps his mana to activate Sisay to put a Teferi, Hero of Dominaria, onto the battlefield. He then activates its -3 ability, targeting Feather. In response, Adam taps his mana to cast a Sheltering Light, targeting Feather, scrying 1 more time. He scries 1 card to the bottom, and then decides to put Feather back into the command zone. Adam will still get this spell back at the end of turn. However, he won't be able to loop it anymore without Feather. Jordan then plays a Blood Crypt as his land for turn and has it enter the battlefield tapped. And Jordan then decides to do his round of Planeswalker activations. He activates Jace's plus one ability, activates Nico Bolas to use Teferi's plus one ability, and then activates Vraska's plus one ability. He goes to his end step, untaps his lands from the delayed Teferi trigger, and then Adam goes to his turn, untapping, drawing, and tapping his mana to cast a Dockside Extortionist. When it enters the battlefield, he generates four treasure tokens. He then uses some of this mana to cast a Heat Shimmer, targeting Dockside. It resolves, and he gets four more treasure tokens. He then sacrifices some of these treasure tokens to equip Sunforger to the token that has haste. He then pays mana to unequip it. However, in response to that trigger, Jordan taps his mana to again activate Sisse to put an Ashiok Dreamrender onto the battlefield, really rending Adam's dreams and not letting him tutor. Adam then uses some of his remaining mana to re-equip Sunforger for the extra damage, and then goes to combat and swings the Dockside copy with haste at Ashiok, who dies. Adam then successfully unequips Sunforger to search up a Swords to Plowshares and casts it targeting Sisse. It resolves, Jordan gains 8 life, and Adam then taps his mana to cast a Simeon Spirit Guide. With nothing left, he goes to his end step, the Dockside token goes away, and Jordan then goes to his turn. He untaps, draws, and activates Vraska's negative 2 ability to destroy Simeon Spirit Guide. He then activates Teferi's plus 1 ability to draw a card. He then activates Nico Bolas's negative 3 ability to destroy Dockside. He then decides to stop playing with his food, goes to combat, and swings his 2-2 illusion at Adam to kill him, winning the game through combat damage. Well, we hope you guys enjoyed the final send-off to Season 2 by showcasing some of your favorite commanders from this season. There's no consultation in this game, so it really let some of these slower and grindier decks shine and show what they can do. It was a really good showing from all of these decks today, actually. Some trying to win, some getting massive value off their commander, some taking two people out of the game, and then, you know, Jordan ended up winning the game, so I guess he played his deck fairly well. But overall, this is a very exciting game to play, and we hope you enjoyed it. I do have to talk about the most valuable card, and I don't think it's any mystery that Suppression Field by far did absolute work this game. Keeping a 5-color deck off of their fetch lands, keeping a Planeswalker deck off of their Planeswalkers, keeping a deck that has an activated ability on their commander off of that activated ability, and then it also hit people that weren't Jordan as well with the Necropotence. It just did a massive amount of work and really deserves the MVP this game. It was definitely worth the keep in the opening hands. Overall, that's a fantastic card to have in that pod. There's no specific instance I want to talk about for this game, but I do want to give some other shoutouts to other really strong cards that were really effective this game, and those cards being Authority of the Consoles, Dawn of Hope, and Kumbal himself. These cards worked really well together and gave Bill a lot of value that allowed him to have the interaction and the cards he needed to stop myself, the Niv-Mizzet player, from going off a little bit earlier. He wasn't able to get the cards he needed due to the Suppression Field and the Necropotence Nanbo, I guess you could call it, but it did allow him to remain relevant and impactful in the game until the turn he was taken out. That being said, that does wrap up our final video on Season 2. We hope you enjoyed it and we hope you're excited for Season 3. Like I mentioned at the beginning of the video, we will be taking a break from seasons and just recording some of our personal decks over webcam for the time being. So Season 3 is coming and we think you'll really enjoy the pod structure we have and the changes we've made from Season 2 in order to make it more entertaining. But in the meantime, you may see some repeated decks. We're just playing what we have available while we're stuck inside and not able to do as much. That being said, we hope you're excited for that as well. We got more content on the way and a lot of exciting stuff in the very near future. That being said, that is all we have for this video. Again, I am Joseph. This is Casually Competitive MTG. We hope you enjoyed the video, and we will see you next time.